Make this thing childproof or something. Ooh. We're gonna be putting this Bluetooth reel right here on this Pro TI rod right here.
Oh, there we go. There we go.
Oh, here comes Kevin.
You can go get him, I don't care.
I'm not leaving.
What's up, guys? This is TJ, aka Fishing with YakPak, and I'm here today in the Walmart parking lot. What we're gonna be doing is the Bluetooth fishing reel. Yeah, you guys absolutely went crazy over that in the last video down in the comments. You guys were like, yes, please go do that. Now, when I was in here the other day and I was looking at this Bluetooth fishing reel, I didn't look at the instructions, the directions, none of that stuff. I have absolutely no clue how this thing even operates. And it's 90 bucks, which is, okay, we're the world's first Bluetooth fishing reel. I don't even know what to say about this thing. But what I do know is we're gonna figure it out together. We're gonna get on the struggle bus and probably miss a couple stops along the way. We're gonna try it. You guys wanted to see it, we're gonna try it. I'm excited to try it. I've never in my life seen anything like what I'm about to go buy. So with all that said, I guess the next step is to get into Walmart here and go buy a $90 Bluetooth fishing reel. Sure, let's just, oh, you guys, forgot, you guys like the, look at that, the Stay Sharp, the YakPak Stay Sharp logo. I love it, comfy, very comfy hoodie here. But anyways, let's go buy a Bluetooth fishing reel. All right, ladies and gents, we're here in Walmart. Oh no, it's locked up. Dude, this thing is massive. Detachable Bluetooth unit. Okay, so I didn't read what this thing did the other day. So as of right now, it seems like I have to buy this reel, I have to download an app, and it's gonna tell me when I've got a bite. I don't know how much I believe that. I don't know how much I trust that. We're gonna find out firsthand. I gotta go get an employee to help me unlock this reel though, cause it's locked up down there. Update, I didn't think it was gonna be this hard to find an employee. But I've literally been looking around the store for like 5 minutes. It is also 7:30 in the morning, so I don't guess there's a lot of people at work right now, but there used to be buttons. Unless I'm crazy. Am I crazy? There used to be buttons in Walmart. It was like press for assistance, and it would always be on like a shelf or a thing like this. You would push it, and something would light up or would make a sound, and then somebody would be right with you. Maybe I'm just crazy. I don't know. Maybe I'm crazy. It's early in the morning. Bear with me. All right, guys, we secured the bag. Let's get her lined up. Oh my gosh. I don't have any fishing line. Rookie. That's some JV stuff right there. I'm gonna head to the house, grab some line, and we'll see you guys at the pond. All right, guys, we just pulled up to the spot. Let's go grab the rod we're gonna put this thing on. And woof! It's a windy one today, boys. It is a windy one today. We got like some 8-foot waves going on out there. It's crazy. We're gonna be putting this Bluetooth reel right here. I have no clue how this thing works. We're gonna find that out together on this Pro TI rod right here. And we're gonna be spooling it up with this really cool looking braid. You guys absolutely love this stuff when I had it on the Pro TI bait caster. So if you want to check this stuff out for yourself, I don't even remember it being, I don't think it's expensive. I think it's 20 bucks for a spool. Maybe it's 16 a spool. I don't even remember, but it's good line. I enjoy it. There's a link for it down in the description below if you want to check it out. If not, cool, whatever. Either way, moving along, let's bust this Bluetooth reel out the package. See if I can do this without pliers. Probably not. Nope, definitely not. God, that makes this thing impossible. It makes this thing childproof or something. Oh, there we go. Need some pre-workout for that next time. My gosh. That was nearly, I'm not gonna lie, that was nearly impossible. Oh, my goodness. We got some mess here. Whew, about to start sweating. You guys hear that? Listen again. I don't know if you guys can hear that. It sounds like there's sand in the reel. This is a ridiculous size reel to put on this 6'10" medium. Yeah, oh, what the heck? Oh my gosh. Wow. That just looks slightly excessive. I don't even know what I'm doing half the time. We're in there like swimwear, baby. That looks absurd. It's a 6'10" with a 4,000 size. What size even is this for real? 6,000. Wow, okay, I was wrong. This is a 6,000 size reel. Wow. I guess there's nothing left to do than to get her lined up. Oh no, oh no, we dropped this. Could have been a disaster. This is some really sick looking line. Look at that. All right, so now that we're rigged and ready to go catch fish, I have to download this on my phone, I guess, and connect it to the reel somehow, some way. So I'm gonna figure out how to do that, and then we're gonna get this thing popping.
All right, so we've got the app downloaded. Let's see. Bluetooth, yes, connect Bluetooth. Smart connect, Bluetooth connect, yes. All right, boys, I think we got it connected. Whenever we catch a fish, it should make a sound. Hold up, it's red flashing. Oh, there's the blue. Okay, we're good. Yep, we're good. I think it's supposed to make some kind of crazy sound if it feels like tension on the other end of the line. So I would assume whether it be a fish or get snagged or whatever. So that took long enough. Let's go get on the water and actually try to catch something with this bad boy.
Yeah, this 6,000 size reel on this little rod doesn't make too much sense.
So apparently what this reel is supposed to do is send a signal when I get a bite or when it feels tensioned, when it feels like tension pulling, it's supposed to immediately send an alert to my phone. So we will see how that goes, but I'm over here right now on this like windblown point. So let's just see how this goes. I mean, dude, the wind, if I turn this way, it's crazy. The wind is crazy blowing.
There we go. Fish on, baby. Let's go. Let's go. Right here at the bank. Let's go. Let's go, baby. Yes, sir.
This reel literally gave me like a millisecond like ding or whatever sound. That was a crazy wild sound that it made. Literally gave me one like split second right as he tugged on it. That's freaking awesome though. Let's go.
Thanks for playing, my dude. Say what's up to YouTube. Catch you next time.
Yes!
There we go.
What is that? Is that a pipe or a fish?
Oh, that was not, that was a pipe. Boy, that bite alarm sounded vicious.
I swear I just saw this thing flash. Oh, it's blue. Okay. I was gonna say, I thought I seen it flash red for a second. I don't know what red means unless it's the battery going dead.
Oh, here comes Kevin.
Yeah. Do what? No fishing. It's a public park, man. No, I know that. I know it's, I know that. It's a public park though. You're like the third person that's come and said something to me though. It's public. I don't know what to tell you. It's literally alligators. Okay. I know. I know there's alligators in the water in Florida. I know that. I understand that. So what's the difference? What's the difference if somebody on those basketball courts over there falls down or gets dunked on and breaks their neck? But I'm out here just fishing. Like, Naeem, I'm not bothering nobody. But you got dudes that fight over there every Friday night on the basketball court. I bet you don't say nothing to them, though. You can go get him. I don't care. I'm not leaving. That's not happening. It's a public park. Not happening. No, public park, public water. You do what you got to do, Chief. All right, my man, go get him. Dude, I don't know what's up with these people. This is a
This is a public body of water that's owned by Palm Beach. Like, I don't get what they're trying to say. I don't understand. Literally. It's funny. It's just funny because they tell me I can't fish here when legally I 100% can. Also, all the baseball players that do spring training here, they can fish here. So it's not a liability when they fish, but it is when I fish. Nah, that ain't how this works, Chief. You don't get to pick and choose. Not on public property. Nope. Oh, let's go. Oh, the bite alert didn't even have time to go off. Let's go. Second bite of the day, the thing didn't even have time to go off. That may be why I was seeing those red flashes on the reel, so I'll have to check that here in a second. But nonetheless, great chunky South Florida fish. Let's go, baby. Peace. Well, here's a little update for you. It's been, since the second fish we caught, it's been probably 35 minutes or so. Haven't heard from the security guy. Obviously, he knew he was in the wrong. He probably just got bored. He probably went and told his manager or his boss or whatever they call it, supervisor. And the supervisor's like, yeah, dummy, this is public property. Like, what do you mean? You can't tell somebody to leave. They're like somebody on a boat fishing on Lake Okeechobee. And then, like, fully legal, fishing license, like, everything legal. Boat registered, insured, everything. And then, like, another boater comes up and says, hey, man, you got to leave. You can't fish here. Yeah, nah, chief, not how that works. But they do have security here because this is, like, a multi-million dollar complex, right? So, and it's owned by the Nationals and the Astros. The two baseball teams, it's their spring training facility. So I understand why they have security, obviously. Like, you don't want people breaking in the stadium and hitting dingers and stuff like that. I mean, you know, but they don't want like equipment and stuff to go missing, all that other good stuff. Anyways, I'm gonna go plug this reel up in the truck really quick to see if we can get it charged back up a little bit. All right, ladies and gentlemen, it seems that we have quite the issue. I think the reel is bad. I think it doesn't work. So let me show you guys something. So this is the charger right here, and it goes into the reel right there. For whatever reason, it's not working. So what I'm gonna do, and I've literally sat here for 20 minutes trying to figure it out, but number one, it's already complicated as it is, and I just really can't even figure it out. So I'm gonna take the line off of it, obviously, because I want my line. I really want my line. And I'm gonna take it back to Walmart and exchange it for another one, and I'm gonna bring you guys along with me. Why not, right? All right, let me go put this in the truck, and then we'll head to Wally World. Off to Walmart we go. This is gonna be very interesting because I can't find the receipt to exchange it. So I don't know if they're gonna take it back. I don't know. We're gonna see though. We're gonna find out together. I guess worst case scenario, they don't have it and I just have a broken fishing reel. Ah, okay. Well, we're now out of Walmart, and unfortunately they didn't have any more of those reels. So I couldn't, so many beeps. I couldn't do a one-for-one swap. So what they did was they just refunded me to, which actually, surprise, that's really awesome, Walmart. Thank you very much. But I guess they're able to look that up on your like card that you purchased the item with. Like you put your card in and then they scan the item. I don't know, it was really weird. But I mean, so I guess I'm gonna be on the lookout for those to come back out. What I think would be really awesome is maybe trying like a Bluetooth combo or something like that. I don't know. I'm gonna pull over right here and talk to you guys for a second. I'm not driving with no seatbelt in like the main road. I'm in the Walmart parking lot and it's clearly, I mean, it's empty, but I'm gonna turn this off. I need to get some gas. Oh, anyways, well, I hope you guys enjoyed. We were able to catch two fish, which in and of itself, pretty cool. The little alarm feature, I mean, it's cool, I guess. It's that, coming to think about it, now that I really put some thought into it, I feel like that reel was more so meant for either offshore, like saltwater stuff, or live bait fishing, like where you just cast out and then just let it sit. That way, you know, it kind of like, did everybody remember when they were little kids and they were like catfishing, but they had like a little bell on the end of their rod where it would be like, the bell would start ringing when the catfish would like take it. Maybe I'm the only one. I know for a fact I'm not the only one. There's no way I'm the only one. Anyways, maybe I use that reel for the complete opposite
purpose and reason that it should have been used today, but oh well, it is what it is. We managed to catch two thick fish, and you know your boy loves catching them thick. I'm just saying. Anyways, don't forget to hit this video with a fat thumbs up, and until next time, we'll catch y'all on the next fishing adventure. Peace.